Hey guys, Blackham25 here. Playing Train Simulator. There's my voice, playing Train Simulator once again today. We will be taking LNER A4 class locomotive Bittern. Probably mispronouncing that, honestly. From London, Victoria. Brighton, speed test you out of there. And yeah, you can see she unlike some other guy who is fitted with balancing. And also I can kind of have a few deaths on the trim, so. Out of all the A4 locomotives that you get if you buy this, yeah, she's the one that most resembles modern. Well, so, we've built for the LNER in 1947, the time capsule works, as we've seen in 1866, which is about that way. They almost never do, I think. Yeah, they're in the 1870. Alright? And they're all over the 1870. It's such a little thing that you could, that I think you could change so easily. Oh boy, that pressure is increasing again. I'm checking by the seat pack that is by the seat pack station. I'm fairly sure that that is one of the most iconic sets in London. Yeah, for the moment we'll build up speed. You know the great this point when you've done it down the... Flying out to whatever this station is called. Well, it would be Battersea Park. Yeah, I was thinking, like, actually, wait a second. And then suddenly, whoosh, quick change in direction. Comes back. There we go. We're going to throw her up to 100% now. Right, so she was built originally number 4464, which is delivery you see her in now, and now she was in preservation. She was renumbered 19 and 16th of August, so 1946 and 3 numbering scheme, and then the number of 6001 that they were showing us, and 10th of October, 1948. Oh, yeah, we're gaining some speed. Once again, using the slope to build up speed. And it, unlike most of the other forms of racing, I guess, or most of the speed record, for locomotives, you were allowed to use... to use any kinds to gain... and speed. There we go. I believe that's quite a good start going at 70. And you are saying that. Right, she's one of the six to survive in preservation, and one of three currently certified for mainline use. She isn't actually currently certified, she's away from restoration. We'll get to that later. Alright. In preservation, she has also won the identities of a number of scrap classmates, including the first of those for class 2509 Silver Link, and most recently as 4492 Dominion of New Zealand. Right, so like the other members of this class, Britain has won many liveries when she was released. She's won Jack Blue livery and this. And then, I believe you know most of the dealers were reprinted to wartime black on 14th of November 41, and May 1933, the tender was modified into some of the things it was sometimes intended to compete with the spouse, turning out to set the views to save scarce materials and labor, while reducing the number of methods by half. So that one I had to run before. But it wasn't on my mind, I think. It's also been subject to change such as down to a new chief mechanic engineer at Thompson for the product of the northeastern area of the Springs Rogers County. Men in black until Central Mass 47 and repainted into the Army and Postal Cavalry of Upstream of Mount Lanning, which she doesn't have. Well, unless. Yeah, we'll be turning off here. Alright, so the final repaint for her was in the first row in 23 and 27 and 52. She has had some variations across her livery. Yeah, so for her, she had a red background to her nameplate. Yeah, so it was used. It was usually black. But also the red background circa 1966 to bring three livery variations. Only the boiler band were lined out except for the firebox boiler band, which was glowing green. I hope this is interesting because it didn't give you much info while doing this, otherwise it should be green. Alright, let's just set this to the end. There's the injectors. So definitely the other. And put a dialing condenser there, which is longer than a firebox boiler band as well. It's not worse if I showed my map on the right hand, looking from the front bucket. This one was marked with date set, so for, I think for the main carry, I thought I could do in 1960. No, that's not bad. But we are about to lose speed on the side. So, in most of the way, Fortune was fitted with the side bouncer and similar to the GU. The bouncer were removed during an overhaul and 20 second of September 14th, 1941. The return unit was put on 6th September 1947. AWS was fitted on 30 December, which is a full width of industrial in 1950. Also something we've read about before. Speed indicators for the 6th December in 1960. Or as they were approaching the point as the AWS kicks off, I call it. Alright, so she has received Boris Johnson Ralph Wedgwood. Vienna, companies from Israel, from Union of South Africa, from London, Vienna, companies from Israel, like I said. One from Mali, another one from Union of South Africa, and one from Silver Fox. Now, this is where things get interesting. Damn it, just that few seconds again. You know, I'm not stopping, I'm keeping going. Because I believe most of us knew this wasn't going to be the speed record breaking one. I'm not resigning this, I've had too many of those. So I was like, oh, okay, this is about to cook off. I look down, and it cooks off while I'm looking at that. That's probably when you're traveling at high speeds, you need to react instantly. I don't understand why they do that. Oh well. Don't particularly care about the real stuff. The safety is about to cook off, I'm fairly sure. And I'm pumping water in. Even after the safety cook off, there's still. well, doing the best in talking about the plot, so you have to tell that I'm not responding. Well, I have accepted that the minimum plan is going to be my fastest plan. Maybe quite a few things like that. So Billing has had just one tender for that one 3 or 5 6 years of the non-corridor design. I'm not entirely sure what that means. So that goes up again. The major overhaul was tendering these tracks in 2007, Does that mean there's like a corridor through it to allow through access to the tunnels or something? I think this is used based on Heath and New Tracks and Falling, which is a stopping point on the second thing in the Tracks. And New Tracks, early in her career, she suffered some collision damage, essentially, with she's transferred to Gateshead on 20th March 2021. This is not a fast road method. The heavy road informing information should get to the end of the year where it goes into the next phase. At the end of the war nationalization from Dunham Records, we were referred by Sarah Chen to try to be expressive of the war years. So we've gone back up to speed fairly quickly at least. We shouldn't have lost too much time. Yeah, boiler pressure for the moment is not that important. Let's take a look at it. Please think that I can always take that out. So now we are going to put in a 1,000 from Prince Death's Ember. We're trying to St. Margaret's on 20th of October 62. Therefore, revival was short-lived, as the steamboat services were hosted by Beaverhead Services and Trading Company to start making the spread. For a short period, Bethlehem was moved to Ferryhead Aberdeen on 10th of November 1963, and then to Evanhill and Glasgow, the service lasted 3 years. Bethlehem had the dubious honour of heading her last April Glasgow to Aberdeen, and thus bringing the curtain down on 30 years of service. And she was brought for preservation to several major problems, such as the plane being cracked quite badly. These problems were known to be odd, but were only lightly repaired, since the ground steam would have been uneconomic to completely repair the aircraft. This in turn affects her life in preservation, and then they now have been put in place again so that she is actually in September. Withdrawn on 3rd of September 1966. Increase them. Good. Alright. She was sold to Jeff Jewell on 5th December 66. It initially operated from New York Depot, a site of National Railway Museum today, on various steam trains, the top trains and other symphonies by the long career. Soon spread into a new idea. When President's fleet was LMER, Pepper Train, Class 18605-23 from British Rail in 1968. Bethlehem and six passengers were to the Denton Railway Centre in Glossop, maybe, right, that's actually quickly checked in. Yes, they're going well. These are all promoted to Denmark's running, and in late 1987, the NRPG took charge of the North American Railway Company. 60532 was moved to Imperial Chemical Industries, works at the Edgemont T-Sound. on the sports man on Monday from December 1991. Second most total attendance. Yes, his method three. Historically represent Palmyra and long lost his 2001. This will be displayed at the Stevens Memorial Museum in Newcastle upon Tyne and Silver. Alright, let's get some more points in the later. Right, so Safe Holding, quote unquote, was displayed at the National Railway Museum, and the Court of Law was displayed at 7-4-4-6-8-9 and 4-5-9-2 more progressive. Marek had just worked at Chariot Connect in Doncaster, so one of the presidents was brutally using a steel gear 27 leg to give the impression to be good steel. Union of South Africa was headed with a 10-year time overhaul. The weekend of 5th July 2008, to go into 3 assists for the first time ever on display at the National Railway Museum in New York. Keeping a close eye on the steam generation, right? Still keeping up, but just barely at this time. Right. That's a good way to show you. Right, so if you're going to Jesus, first time I've ever spoken up on this. And it also just a matter of one. The British Railways line being up in the current British Railways number 60019. So the first service train since 1971-1972-2007 after 6 years of restoration. Numerous tests and modifications. The repair for that $1,300 on 1972-2007 during the other cost of this end of the same steam dial, following their way to dining coach from Alice to Arton. Since then she has been running and has been used on normal service since February 22nd and 25th March 2008 on the Spencer from the Times of Tanker, Miss Dealing, and the Royal Press Line, Stanley Thomas. She also booked a Spencer from 9th, 17th August 2008. Okay, we closed the injectors and I'm fairly sure. Still going up, so I guess we keep pumping it in. So she intends on settling to the South by Depot in London, while she is figure trying to water tenders, both for the port and the special. After that, we can do the business with us on the coaster, so after the first visit, we can still have a record. On Saturday, the 1st of December 2007, on a charter from London, Kings Cross to York, and since then, she has called several more interviews in Britain. On the 20th of July, she had a 188-mile run from Kings Cross to York non-stop, using a second tender to avoid need to stop on each city from York and James Cruz, carrying the headboard to Brighton Bell, publicized the engine of Brighton Bell restoration project by Fred Bell Trust. The first time they're having a water capacity of 5,000 gallons of coal, the second time the tender only was carrying an extra 9,000 gallons of water, and was thought this would give pressure in the range of about 250 miles. Additional stops are desirable in any case, for things to be kind of addressing carrier distribution coming farther. A long staff run on the East Coast mainland has not been achieved since the 1968 King's Cross to Edinburgh High, where 4.72 King's Cross was also a second tender. Could have come some more in. It's safe to say, awesome, but they're off. In June, in the Top Gear race to North, run using the new Gold Cup now 608162. So maybe they had been achieved from running to Edinburgh and the East Coast Mainland with water stops and their station stops. Also, first since the 1968 run of number 4472. In the winter of 2010 and 2011, the locomotive situation was completed with Kismetic, Kermana, and Mondrian. Of the locomotive, a scrap cast of 4.92 to the moon in New Zealand. This conversion also included the attention of the locomotive in the area of Black and Blue. The fitting of Gresley's original sound visor, you also see the hands of the locomotive was masquerading as 2.39 Silver Lake. And the patent of its wheels are original coronation ride. Oh! Never mind, we're up to 120, this might actually be good. I don't know anymore about to go up here, so who knows. On legs. Now legs. Oh, we're up to 120. That's good. One more second, I have to get up to the speed. But I doubt she's going to be able to get close to our mileage, because we are definitely going to lose speed. Alright, let's send her into the Hornley. And there's that one. As the original 4492, right, so I'm just continuing. As the original 4492 of the New Zealand government airways, 5-time whistle took short efforts in production, suitable whistle was borrowed from Glenbrook Vintage Railway New Zealand. The original Dominion of New Zealand was one of 5 airways in the Commonwealth countries for the coronation service, and on Saturday, the coronation of King Charles VI and Queen Elizabeth in 1937. Two of the 5 coronation members were surrounded by preservation. Dominion of Canada became a Royal Museum and 6009. Union of South Africa owned by John Cameron and the first photograph of Nelson Mandela. He was due to remain in this livery for 3 years, having 4.64 American Institute in 1912. The locomotive had reverted to its own identity as 4.64 Britain and Gold Leaf Lettering. Right. We're gaining speed. Even though we're going uphill. That's good. That's a small water. Unless this bit's going to get steep and close to the speed. This is actually looking good. Don't think it would be good considering we're just going the water. But who knows? Right. To celebrate the 75th anniversary of her sister's Mallory's competing with record-breaking 126 miles per hour run, she ran 3 special travels around the East Coast mainland. Then she became the first locomotive on preservation to be allowed to break the 75 mile per hour speed limit as seen locomotives have on the UK mainland. Now we're playing about 4464 going up to 90 miles per hour, as long as it passed some rigorous tests beforehand. That's what she did. Yeah, that was gonna screw us up. Because we are currently up to 123 close to us. Well, not really, but still fairly close. Alright. All of these chairs involved better not getting to and from York, so it can still be displayed along with the 5 other preserved air floors, including mine and National Railway Museum. On 29th of June 2013, she set a new speed up for the preserved steam locomotive. According to official timers on the footplate, it achieved a maximum speed of 92.8 miles per hour, as the Bedfordshire, the first of its high speed runs, the average speed that ran from London speeds across the world. The remaining 2 engines were scheduled for July, the heat rolled during the summer as well as present weather issues later. In the year of services, the York Newcastle Time T Street and the York London Speed first couple of the release schedule for 15th December and 7th of December. During the Time T Street one, Britain broke its own speed record set just a few months prior by reaching a maximum speed of 93 miles per hour. Okay then, tunnel! technical thing is put a proof number in the box. Some of that's going to my system like my lines and this product here is going to be for the North Quantum Service from May 2018 to IMWR2. As of May 2018, Bethlehem is stored in the queue of engines away from the North Quantum Base. To ourselves, focus on getting 605 and 70,000 back on May 9. There currently, very soon there won't be a single running A4. Which I'm kind of standing up. Currently there is a Union of South Africa. She's going to be with from the chief. To which, well, I sort of understand, like, okay. Okay, short entry. But if you can afford to buy an A4, you can probably afford to run it, at least, like maybe reduce the number of times she runs. And also, people are willing to give money to this thing, like, to ride on it, like, significant amounts of money. Some others back in release, some others 6.0.0.9, or still in front of the Queen, in 2013, Harvey released an individual edition of 1,000 models of Bethlehem 6.0.0.9, then ones with Queen or Double Tenders, Aspects now suffering from London to Europe. This fall in 2014, there are very limited editions of the 6 surviving materials as the Great Divine Collection, including Bethlehem as 4.4.6.4, however. 4-4-6-4 and graphic blue and spray balances. We're done. That actually took longer than most of the others. 1-2-2-4-4. So we're still doing a fairly respectable speed. I mean, 13 miles out. That should be a little over 7 or so minutes. Let's get some water back in. Like I said, I really want to tag on over this thing. And no, I don't mean on the foot plate, although I wouldn't say no to that. I know that that is very unlikely. But wait a minute, I don't know what... like the exact details of like what those other two locomotives are, they're probably in a crew awaiting restoration. In my personal opinion, I would say, unless it has begun, they don't want to do that thing, which is fair enough. Otherwise, I would think an A4 would come first, like one of these things. Like, especially now that it's been announced that Union of South Africa is getting retired. Sir Nigel Gresley is undergoing restoration. She won't be back into mainline running for quite a while, I think. Well, a good while at least, because I think she's basically having an entire boiler room thing on for that show. The reason why I said fairly sure, I'm not 100% sure. Sound of the whistle. They were getting really close to, oh, also, does anybody know if in Ireland there are similar restrictions in terms of speed as in Britain at 75 miles per hour? Don't know what that is in kilometres per hour, so I can't compare it because I've been on a steam train that's gone up to 110. You can see that in my video of the CVs and the cylinder special off the side. Which, like I said, I do, like, even though the train was late, I do recommend you travel with the RPSR at some point. It's well worth it. There we go. You know, I'm currently in that position where I want to nudge it up a bit further. But I know that will not really do us much good. And also, oh, that one bomb past this screw us up, doesn't it? Interesting thunder. We are getting, once again, we've gotten so close to Mario's record. Which does make me wonder, like, what if we didn't get that proper fucking brain. don't want those to cook off. But they won't. That's a fender to me. I've got the fender under that, the top too, if you're going to fill it in there, that would be. Right, I'm going to see if I can, like, you know, brake without using the emergency brake. Okay, that's good. Once again, I hope I don't end up breaking her like I did with a unicycle. Not for long. Not for long. Oh yeah, now there's no hope of getting off. Not that fun. What is that? Right. Oh no, we are still starting, so maybe there is a chance. Oh, I doubt we can get up to that speed in this part, guys. Okay, we've reached 125. We've reached 125. So, better than that become our fastest, 84. Okay, tunnel. Going downhill again. About 3 miles. Can I get past that 126 miles per hour? Don't know, but I'm not putting any more. Oh, I'll put just some water in. No, I doubt we're going to get any faster than 25.3. Well, we're not going to get any faster than 25. Only 126. If we do, it's going to be very surprising. We might give up that ticks up to 126, but that's even after at 126. 2 minutes to go, 125.4. Yeah, not happening. I mean, this is still an impressive speed, don't get me wrong, but... Well, maybe Dwight the Eisenhower now can do better. We should see soon enough, will we not? I'm getting ready to disable that. I'm ready. Right, let's hold on the brakes. What's our speed? 5.4. Okay. Okay, nope. Oh yeah, this is the turn I did. Oh. No, maybe it wasn't. That's going to show up again, isn't it? I'll use the turn on the thunder, although I don't know what I should use. I'll release the brakes slowly because... Oh my god, we're still going very quickly. Especially considering we're approaching a station with buffers. Who cares about the map? Where does this bit lead? Oh, we got a hole, and then it goes to Warland. We're doing some gradual deceleration. That's going to be a screenshot. Or the top thumbnail, sorry. Oh yeah, so he completed in 27 minutes and 31 seconds. Toshi was 125.49. Top 12. Yeah, that was the better in speedrun. I'm button 25, goodbye.